After 2 months researching the Elephant Man's story, examining the skeleton, and looking at the scans, Ruth and John now have sufficient data to recreate Joseph Merrick's voice. They've discovered that on the right side of his face, Merrick's ear canal is blocked. His jawbone is overgrown, and his tongue restricted by a bony growth in the roof of his mouth. Actor Elliot Shrimpton has volunteered to be placed under the same physical constraints as Joseph Merrick, to see what impact it'll have on his speech.
That's it, yeah.
What do you think about
slightly,
that?
And maybe slightly chin, slightly tucked in.
Yeah, so I wanted to do some.
It was almost like there was a sack. He was carrying a sack on his back.
Yeah.
With the flesh.
Just pop over there.
The head and the neck, and this is very good because it immediately kind of, even before he opens his mouth, we can see how it's going to limit his vocal output.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
They then use tape to block Elliot's ear and simulate Merrick's deafness.
So everything in the right side sounds muted.
It will, but paradoxically, you might actually hear yourself better on this side.
Right.
So put a twist tape right over the ear like this. We'll pull the ear down because the ear was, the pinna was pulled down in any case.
A dental plate, specially made to reproduce the bony growths in Merrick's mouth, will restrict Elliot's tongue movement. Now a makeup artist glues on a prosthetic mask to simulate Merrick's lips. This completes the transformation.
Can you just tell us what's on your mind? How do you feel?
I have no power.
Do you feel like a victim?
Melancholic.
I've had, in myself, an odd change. I've gone from thinking of Elliot as an actor to someone that I actually feel responsible for, almost in a doctor-patient role.
The final stage in the process is to record Elliot's voice. This will be sent to the imaging team so that they can make their virtual model of Joseph Merrick talk as well as walk.
So what we're going to do now is we're going to have you read a poem, Elliot, that was used by Joseph Merrick to end his letters. This was not his own poem that he's written. He has adapted it from False Greatness by Isaac Watts.
Uh-huh.
Yes, whenever you're ready to.
I know my home is something odd. That's only me. Is blaming God. Could I create myself anew? I would not have imprisoned you. If I could reach some cold fall or grasp the ocean with a sand, I would be measured by your soul. Your mind is standard to your mind.